sometimes we see different tools that are out there, competitive tools out there, saying that they're network processor driven.
Yeah,
or
sure.
NP processor
driven. Oh, NP, that's my favorite. They don't say network processor, they say NP.
Right. So, I mean, what does that mean?
Well, anybody can be an NP. Anybody can say network processor, right? I'm in the network and I have a processor, so therefore I'm a network processor. Okay. Congratulations. People say it all the time. My always thing is I always take the board out. I show everybody what our board looks like. I show them where the FPGAs are. I show them where the memory is or the capture buffer. I show them where the NPs are. I show them where the general purpose management processor is. Show them how they all interconnect and prove it.
Right.
I mean, why not? I'm proud of the board. I'll be glad to show it to anybody that wants to see it.
Do you want to show it to us now?
Sure.
All right, cool. Let's go.
This is a 10 gig board. Can you see it?
Yep.
All right. We have a 1 gig version. This one has four interfaces. You can see here your physical interfaces go in here. So you slide the modules in. You need four 10 gigs. This is our Altera FPGA. And this is where we do all the layer 2, 3 stuff. So this is all your bit blasting, routing robot, all your standard performance stuff. It also does some stream allocation and how it balances things out for us. But next to it is memory right here. And you can see these are 2 gigs. 2 gigs per interface of capture buffer. But it's actually, so if you wanted to, we'd do some stuff for you, but we could upgrade these later on to like 8 gigs, 16 gigs. As soon as we can do some stuff, some logic and upgrading them and get the form factor right, etc. Make sure the parts don't run out. But that's what they are, the DDR2. This is where all the packets are captured. So instead of having like a 64K capture, you have gigs and gigs of data. Because at 10 gig speeds, you need it. This is the MP. This is a Raza XLR 32. It has 32 cores. Basically, that's the chip right there. It has memory connected to it as well. And you can see here we have 8 gigs of memory, DDR2 memory connected to that as well. And this is where all the processing happens for all layer 4 through 7, all your app traffic, everything. And what's neat about that is, if you notice, that's it. There's no Intel CPU or no AMD or no general purpose CPU. That's it. So this connects to the backplane, and all that does is give management. It's just Ethernet. You can see one right there. If you turn around, there's an open chassis. And this open chassis has our connectors. And this is a blue board, which just means that it's a functional test unit, and first pass board. And you can see here that this is where the Intel CPU is, and this is where the memory is for actually doing management of the box. And this runs Linux, and we manage the box that way. And you can stick all the blades in you want, and there's an actual 1 gig version of this board too, and the 1 gig version looks exactly the same way except for the I.O. The I.O. on the front is a little bit different, and that changes the memory configuration and the FPGA loads, of course, because they have to handle 8 ports instead of 4. So that's the board. That's what it looks like.